are going to start models.
Students, a modal verb is a type of verb which is used to indicate modality, that is, possibility, ability, permission, request, capacity, suggestions, obligation, advice, etc. Words that we use as modals are shall, should, will, would, can, could, be able to, may, might, ought to, and must. Remember, to enter the classroom, you ask your teacher, "Ma'am, may I come in?" In this sentence, may is a modal, which suggests permission, which is polite and formal. Modals cannot be represented alone as a main verb, since they are always used in the helping form. Let's learn them. Students, modals that show ability are, first one is can. Can is used to express ability or capacity. For example, he can lift the box. Next one, she can speak English. In the both sentences, you can see that both of them are showing ability. Let's see the next one. Next one is could. Could is used to express past ability or capacity. For example, when I was young, I could run fast. Next one, Sia could speak English properly by the age of 10. Let's see the next one, be able to. Students, be able to also expresses ability to do something, which is more possible than can. For example, I am able to swim. Next one, he was able to write with both hands. In these examples, you can see that be able to expresses ability to do something. Let's see the modals that express obligation, advice, and suggestion. First one is should. Should is used to make a suggestion or to give an advice. For example, you should get up early in the morning. You can see that this sentence is showing a suggestion. Let's see the next one. We should complete our work on time. It's also showing an advice or a suggestion. Let's see the next one. Must. Must suggests strong obligation, compulsion, and necessity. For example, we must respect our elders. This sentence shows strong obligation. Next one, you must complete your homework before going to bed. This sentence is also showing compulsion. Last one, you must get a good job. This sentence shows necessity. Next one is ought to. Ought to is a type of auxiliary modal verb that is used to express moral duty. It also suggests that it is right thing to do. For example, he ought to look after his parents. This sentence shows moral duty. Next one, there ought to be a ban on cigarette advertising. This sentence shows what is right or sensible thing to do. Next, we'll see the modals that express and ask for permission. First one, may. May is used to suggest permission which is formal in nature and polite. Let's see the examples. First one, Mr. Smith, may I go to the restroom? Next one, you may go as soon as you have finished your exam. Both examples are showing that in first one, someone is asking for permission and next one is showing that someone is giving permission. Let's see the next one, can. We use can to ask for and give permission. Can is less formal than may. For example, can I sit here? You can use my car if you like. Next one is could. We use could for asking permission. Students, could is more polite and formal than can. Let's see the example. Could I ask you something? Let's see the models that express possibility. First one is may. May shows possibility in the present or the future. For example, where are my keys? They may be in the car. This sentence shows possibility. Next one, I may go to the party tonight. This sentence also shows possibility in future. Next one is might. Might indicates weak possibility in the present or future. It is also used as past tense of may. For example, where are my keys? They might be in the car. Next one, they might attend the awards ceremony tonight. Last one, he thought it might rain. These examples are showing possibility, but they are showing weak possibility. Next one is can. Can is used to indicate general and occasional possibility. For example, any child can grow up to be president. Next one, could. Could is used to indicate a very weak possibility. We use could to show that something is possible but not certain. Let's see the examples. They could come by car. Maybe they will come by car, but it's not certain. Next one, they could be at home. Maybe they are at home. Next one, we will see the models that express prohibitions. First one is must not. We use must not to express that something is prohibited or forbidden because it's a rule. Let's see the examples. You must not use your mobile phone in the school. Why? Because it's a rule. Next one, ought not to. It indicates that something should not be done because it is a duty. For example, students ought not to make a noise in the class. Next one is would. Would is used to make polite requests in English. For example, would you mind closing the door? Next one, would you mind turning down the radio? In both the examples, would is used to show polite requests. Next one, the models that express promise, intention and willingness. Will and shall. Will is used with all persons and shall is used with first person to suggest intention and willingness in their normal uses. However, when promise is suggested, we use will with first person subjects and shall with other subjects. For example, I'll help you. It's a promise. Next one, he will complete his work. Next one, I shall buy vegetables today. Second sentence is showing intention and last one is showing willingness.